we will be making for our project today. And the materials that we will need to make this pendant are a 14 millimeter Rivoli, and I will be using a Potomac crystal Rivoli in the Peridot AB color. We will need some RounTrio beads, and I will be using the Faceted RounTrio beads in the Turquoise shimmer color. Now you can use either the Faceted RounTrios or the Smooth RounTrios for this project. We will need some seed beads. We are going to need some 8-0 seed beads, and I will be using the Miyuki Duracoat Galvanized Seafoam for the 8-0s. We will need some 11-0 seed beads, and I will be using the Miyuki Duracoat Champagne Gold for the 11-0s. And we'll need some 15-0 seed beads, and I'll be using the Miyuki Duracoat Champagne Gold for those as well. We will need some 6mm round beads, and I will be using some Czech glass pearls, and this is the powder green shiny color. We'll also need some 4mm fire polish beads, and I have some right here that are a bluish green color. I'm not sure the exact name for these, but that's the color they have. For beading thread, I'll be using the Wildfire .006 in the green color, and I'll be using a size 12 beading needle. You'll also need something to cut your thread with, and I'll be using my thread zap. So let's get our materials together and we'll get started on this project. To start off, we'll need 5 feet of beading thread, and I've already added my thread to my needle. We'll want to add 28 11-0 seed beads to our thread, and then we'll want to sew back through all those seed beads again to form a circle, leaving about a 6-inch tail that we will use to sew towards the back of our beadwork. So go through all those beads again, making sure that we don't miss any. Once we've gone through all of our 11-0 seed beads, we'll want to tie one single knot. With our tail thread. I'm going to pull tight. I'm going to push my tail thread out the way. And then now I want to go through the next 7 11-0 seed beads. Pull tight. Here we'll pick up a 15-0 seed bead, an 8-0 seed bead, and a 15-0 seed bead, and we're going to sew back through this last 11-0 that our thread is now exiting. And your beads will sit like that. We're going to sew through the next 7 11-0 seed beads. Again, we're going to pick up a 15-0, an 8-0, and a 15-0, and we're going to sew back through the last 11-0. That our thread is now exiting. We're going to repeat this 2 more times. So sew through the next 7 11-0 seed beads. Pick up a 15-0, an 8-0, and a 15-0, and sew back through the last 11-0 that your thread is exiting. And pull tight. And one more time, we'll go through the next 7 11-0 seed beads. And you should be exiting right where your tail thread is. Pull tight. We'll pick up a 15-0, an 8-0, and a 15-0. And we're going to go back through that last 11-0 that our thread is exiting. Pull tight. This is what you'll have. We're going to come up this 15-0 that we just added. So come back up that 15-0 seed bead. We'll go through the 8-0 seed bead and then go down through the next 15-0 seed bead. And pull tight. We'll pick up 6 11-0 seed beads. We're going to come over to this next set of 15-0s and an 8-0. We're going to go up through the 15-0. Go through the 8-0. And then back down through the next 15-0. We'll pick up 6 11-0 seed beads again. And we'll do the same thing. We'll come over to this next 15-0. We're going to come up through that 15-0. Go through the 8-0. Go down through the next 15-0. And pull tight. You're going to pick up 6 more 11-0 seed beads. Come over to the next 15-0 and go up through that 15-0. Pull tight. Go through the 8-0. And down through the next 15-0. And then we'll pick up 6 more 11-0 seed beads again. And come over to this next 15-0. Now we're going to go up through that 15-0. And then we're going to go through the 8-0. And we'll get ready to add on our round trios. So this is what you'll have at this point. Alright, so we're going to add our round trios on right now. To do that, we'll want to pick up an 11-0, an 8-0. We'll pick up one of our round trios by going through one of the end holes. an 8-0, and then another 11-0. We're going to come over to this next 8-0 seed bead, and we're going to go through that. So again, we'll pick up an 11-0, an 8-0 seed bead. We'll go through, we'll pick up a round trio by going through one of the end holes, an 8-0 and an 11-0 seed bead. And then we're going to come over to the next 8-0 seed bead on our beadwork and go through that. And this is what you'll have. So you'll need to do that two more times for a total of 4 round trio beads. Once you add on all your round trios and your seed beads, you want to go through and reinforce this round one more time. So after adding your round trios and then reinforcing that last round, you'll want to be exiting from the 8-0 seed bead after your round trio that sits in the middle between the two round trios. So you'll be exiting from this 8-0 seed bead in the middle. Here we're going to pick up an 11-0 seed bead, a 15-0 seed bead, an 11-0 seed bead, an 8-0 seed bead. Then we'll get an 11-0 seed bead, a 15-0 seed bead, and an 11-0 seed bead. And this is what you should have. You should have 7 beads on your needle. So you'll have an 11-0, a 15-0, an 11-0, your 8-0, an 11-0, a 15-0, and then another 11-0. We're going to come over to this next side of our beadwork. In the middle, there will be another 8-0 seed bead. We want to come through that middle 8-0 seed bead. So that CB right that sits right there, we'll sew through that. And we want to make sure that the beads that we're adding sit on the back of our beadwork, which is what we're working on now, the back of our bezel. And that's what they'll look like. So again, we'll pick up 7 more beads. We're going to get an 11-0, a 15-0, an 11-0, an 8-0, an 11-0, a 15-0, and then another 11-0. We're going to come over to the next side of our beadwork, and we're going to go through that middle bead, that middle 8-0 seed bead. Make sure your beads sit towards the back of your bezel. So we'll do that 2 more times, an 11-0, 15, and 11. Grab an 8, an 11, a 15, 11. And go through the next middle 8-0 seed bead. And right now we can actually sit our Rivoli into our beadwork. We want to sit, since this is the back of our beadwork, we want to sit our Rivoli so that it's facing down. And make sure those beads that we just added sit on the top of the back of the Rivoli. Now pull tight. And one more time, we're going to pick up 7, those 7 seed beads. So we'll get an 11-0, a 15-0, an 11-0. We'll grab an 8-0, and then we'll do an 11-0, a 15-0, and then another 11-0. We're going to come over to this next side and go through that middle 8-0 seed bead. And pull tight, and this is what you'll have. We want to come down through the first 4 seed beads that we added from that first set of 7. So we should be coming exiting from that middle 8-0 seed bead. And here we're going to pick up an 11-0, an 8-0 and another 11-0. And we're going to go through the middle bead in the next set of 7, which will be our 8-0 seed bead. So we'll go through that 8-0 seed bead. Grab some more 11-0s. So again, we'll pick up an 11-0, an 8-0, and another 11-0. We're going to come over to this next set of 7 from the previous round, and we're going to go through that middle bead, which is the 8-0 seed bead. And we'll pull tight. An 11-0, 8-0, and 11-0. Go over to the next set of 7 and go through that middle 8-0 seed bead. Pull tight, and then one more time. We're going to grab an 11-0, an 8-0, and another 11-0, and come over to this 8-0 seed bead. And pull tight. Now we want to go through the first 2 seed beads from that last round of 3. So we'll go through this 11-0 and this 8-0 seed bead. And pull tight. Here we'll pick up 2 11-0 seed beads. We're going to come over to the next set of 3 from the last round. And we're going to go through that middle 8-0 seed bead. Pull tight, pick up 2 11-0s, come over to the next set of 3, and go through the middle 8-0 seed bead. Okay, 2 more 11-0s, go over to the next set of 3, go through that middle 8-0 seed bead, and I went through too many beads here. Just going to go through that middle 8-0 seed bead. Pull tight. And then 2 more 11-0s. And go through that next middle 8-0 seed bead from the last round. And pull tight. Going to reinforce this round by going through the beads I just added one more time. Once you've gone through and reinforced that round and you're exiting from one of those middle 8-0 seed beads, you're just going to come up back up to the side of your beadwork. So I'm going to go through this 11-0 and then this 8-0. I'll come up these 3 seed beads right here. I'm going to go through this middle 8-0 seed bead. I'm going to come through these next 2 seed beads. That's after our 8-0. And then I'm also going to go through the round trio bead. Now we want to step up to the second hole of a round trio bead. I'm going to place our working thread to the side. I'm going to come back. This is what the back of our bezel looks like right now. I'm going to go back over to the front of the bezel, and I'm going to place a needle onto our tail thread. And I want to sew this tail thread towards the back of our bezel and end off the tail thread. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to come through this next 110C bead from that first round. I'm going to come up through the 15OC bead. We'll go through this 8OC bead. Going to go over to the back of my beadwork. We're going to come down these three seed beads right here. Well, actually four. We're going to come down through that the three seed beads and then the 8OC bead that follows. And basically we're going to work our way to that that last round we did on the back of the bezel. And here's where we want to tie a couple of knots for our tail thread and then end off our tail thread. So with our working thread exiting from this middle hole of our round trio, we want to pick up an 110 seed bead, an 80 seed bead. We'll pick up one of our 6mm beads, an 80 seed bead, and then another 110 seed bead. We're going to come over to this next round trio and then go through that middle hole. And pull tight. Again, an 110, an 80, 6mm, an 80, and then another 110. And then we're going to come over to this round trio bead and go through the middle hole. And repeat that two more times. And as you come through that last round trio, pull tight, and this is what you'll have. We're going to step up through this last end hole of our round trio. And here we're going to pick up 5 110 seed beads. We're going to come over, we're going to skip over these two beads and then come right over to our 6mm round bead and go through that. And pull tight. We'll pick up 5 110 seed beads. We're going to come over, we're going to skip over these next two seed beads and come over to our round trio and then go through that last end hole, the one we haven't gone through yet, and pull. And that's what you'll have. We'll repeat that, so we'll get 5 110 seed beads. Go through our 6mm round bead and 5 110 seed beads, and go through the next end hole go through the end hole of our next round trio. So continue to do that all the way around our pendant. Okay, so now we're exiting from this round trio bead here. We're exiting from that last hole. We're going to come up through these 5 11-0 seed beads. Here we're going to pick up 3 15-0s, 1 11-0, and then 3 more 15-0 seed beads. That's what you'll have. We're going to skip over this 6 millimeter bead, and we're going to come up through the next 3 11-0 seed beads. So we'll come through those 3 11-0 seed beads. So we're exiting from the middle of that set of 5. Here we're going to pick up an 11-0, a 15-0. We're going to pick up one of our 4 millimeter fire polish beads. We'll pick up a 15-0 and then an 11-0. We're going to come over to the next set of 5 11-0 seed beads. And we're going to go through that middle bead. So we're going to skip over all these beads here and skip over our round trio bead. Come over to the next set of 5 11-0 seed beads and go through that middle bead and pull. We're going to go down through the next 2 11-0 seed beads. And here we're going to pick up 3 15-0 seed beads, 1 11-0 seed beads, 1 11-0 seed bead, and then 3 more 15-0 seed beads. So that's what we'll have. We're going to skip over this 6 millimeter round bead, and then we're going to come up through the next 3 11-0 seed beads. That's what you'll have. So here we're going to pick up an 11-0, a 15-0, one of our 4 millimeter fire polish beads, a 15-0, and then another 11-0. And let those beads drop down. We're going to come over to our next set of 5 11-0 seed beads. We're going to come through that middle bead that sits at the top and pull. And then we're just going to continue to repeat that sequence all the way around our pendant. So I'm getting ready to add my last 4 millimeter fire polish bead. I'm going to come over to this next set of 5 11-0 seed beads and go through that middle bead that's sitting at the top and pull tight. I'm then going to go down through the next 2 11-0 seed beads. And then we want to go up through these 3 15-0 seed beads and then go through that 11-0 seed bead that sits in the middle of that set of 7. And here we're going to add a loop for our pendant. So we'll pick up 7 11-0 seed beads. And we're going to come back through this 11-0 that our thread is now exiting. We're going to reinforce this loop by going through all those beads again. And then we'll go through that 11-0 C bead at the bottom of our loop. And this is what you'll have. I'm gonna go down through the next three 15-0 C beads. And I'm gonna come through these three 11-0s. And then I'll work my way over to this 4mm fire polish bead. And what I wanna do now is just basically go around the edge of the beadwork and reinforce the beads we added in the last round. So we'll sew through our seed beads that are along the edge of the pendant. So you continue to do that, and then I'll show you how to sew through to the back of the pendant to tie off and end your thread. So after going around the edge of the pendant and reinforcing, we want to make our way over to one of the outer holes of our round trios. Once I'm exiting one of the outer holes right now, I'm going to actually step down and go through the middle hole of that same round trio bead. And then I'm going to go down to the I'm going to call it the inner hole of that same round trio bead. So the other end hole of that same round trio bead. I'm going to work my way over to this middle 8-0 seed bead. So I'll go through these two seed beads and then go through that middle 8-0. Now I'm going to turn over to the back of the beadwork. I'm going to just push my needle through to the back. And here's where we want to end our thread. So I'm exiting out of that 8-0 seed bead. I'm going to come down these three seed beads and just begin to tie a couple of knots. And then I'm going to work my way over to over here and tie a few knots here, and then I'll end my thread. Okay, so this is the completed pendant. I want to show a few additional pendants that I made with this design in a couple of different colors. So we have this purple and silver one, and we have this pink and bronze and copper one, and we have another bluish green one. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to, you can go to the Potomac Bead Company YouTube channel to find hundreds of additional tutorials, or you can go to the PotomacBeads.com website to find tons of patterns. If you need any supplies that were used in the making of this pendant, you will find them on the PotomacBeads.com website. And we hope that you'll join us in